Hello and welcome back to Particular Pixels. I'm Charling and this is Observer. Observer is a first-person cyberpunk horror game from the Blooper Team, the same studio that made Layers of Fear. Unfortunately, I did not get a chance to play that. However, what grabbed my attention about Observer was the cyberpunk setting of the game, and even though I don't usually play these types of horror games, I decided to give this one a try. The game takes place in 2084. You play as Dan Lazarski, an elite neural detective known as an observer, and you're part of the corporate funded police unit whose sole purpose is to hack and invade suspects' minds. That doesn't sound like a breach of privacy at all. Observer is very story-based, however, and I think it's best experienced without spoilers. So in this video, I'm not going to talk about any story-specific stuff, and I'll try and keep the footage as spoiler-free as possible. I may include some clips from later sections in the game, but I'll try not to include the story sections or things that give away parts of the story. But what I will say, though, is that you're looking for your son. You get a phone call from him right at the beginning of the game, and you go to meet him at the apartment complex where he's staying. A lockdown happens so that no one can leave, and your son is not where he's supposed to be, so you basically have to follow leads in order to find out what happened to him and what's going on with the lockdown. However, in this video, I'm going to focus on the gameplay aspects of this particular title. The game has two distinct sections, the parts where you're wandering around the apartment complex in the real world investigating clues, trying to find the next lead that's going to point you toward your next objective and closer to find out what's going on. So you'll be talking to the various residents throughout the apartment complex, through their doors or investigating the various crime scenes in the game. The apartment complex is actually quite big, it's got a number of different floors, a lot of apartments. You can't enter most of them, but there are a few that you can enter and rooms that you can search and things like that. The dialogue, for the most part, I think is done pretty well, and I think that Rutger Hauer does a really good job with his performance. I thought it was very, very impressive. You'll also be able to use two scanners in the game, an electronic scanner that scans electronic devices, and a biometric scanner which can scan organic matter. And you'll be using both of these to scan for various things and clues relating to certain crime scenes as you progress further and further into the game. However, the majority of the electronics that you scan with the electronic scanner in the game don't serve any purpose. Motherboards or CPUs that you find in the cupboard, or radios or door mechanisms and such. You can scan them, it tells you what brand it is, and kind of that's it. There are some very specific items that you scan at the various crime scenes in the game that are going to update your objectives, but that is really about it. Now, I understand that this probably adds some immersion into the game, but after playing through the game, I can say there are very few things that you actually really use the scanner for that served any purpose. And unfortunately, the same can be said for the bioscanner. There are, of course, some blood splatters and things at the crime scenes that you can scan, but outside of that, there's almost nothing else in the world that you can scan with the bioscanner. And I do like that these were included, but I felt that they could have been put to better use or had at least more fleshed out game mechanics associated with them. Your character also needs to take pills at various points in the game. When he gets stressed, which usually happens after he comes out from hacking somebody's mind, or at certain points in the story after specific scripted events, you're going to need to take pills to calm yourself down. Otherwise, your character is going to start suffering from all kinds of visual anomalies, so you press tab, you take your pill, and so on and so forth. Refills to these pills can be found throughout the various game locations. I found quite a lot of them, but the game doesn't give you a clear indication of how many of these pills you have remaining, or there's no easy way to tell if you need more. And throughout my entire playthrough, I never felt that it was important for me to find more, or even if I needed the extra ones. I had no idea if the extra ones I was picking up were even being used. Was it topping up the amount of pulls that I had, or were they just being picked up and not being used? I couldn't tell. The game doesn't give you that information. The moments where your character feels stressed and your vision goes strange usually happen at very specific scripted moments in the game. Unlike something like Amnesia, for example, where your sanity was a dynamic thing that changed based on what is happening around you and whether or not you had light and that kind of thing. In Observer, it's not. It all seems very, very scripted, which sort of downplays the need for you collecting these pills. The other sections of the game play out when you hack into the minds of others. This is where the psychological horror elements mainly come into play. These sections, for the most part, are very, very linear. They funnel you through a specific direction, and all you really do is walk. The world around you changes, repeating rooms, there's voices, there's corrupted visuals, and all that kind of thing. It's all very unsettling, and I think the game really does an excellent job, both visually and audio-wise, to mess with you. There are some puzzles to be found, And there were a few sections where you had to avoid an enemy, and if the enemy saw you, you'd have to restart from a checkpoint. But for the most part, it was a linear walk through their memories to fill in some of the background story behind what happened to the particular person you were hacking. Now, some of these sections can be incredibly confusing as well due to the fact that there are so many visual anomalies going on and the fact that there is no indication of what you're supposed to do or where you're supposed to go, so you'll end up kind of going round and round in circles. There are computer terminals in the real world as well where you get to read emails and notes that fill in more of the backstory, and there's even a little mini game that you can play with each computer, giving you access to another level of this particular mini game with them getting harder and harder. And I thought this was a pretty cool addition. It gives you a little bit of a break from the constant psychological bombardment that's coming from the game. There are also some collectibles in the game, pictures of the various developers scattered throughout the level, which you can find, which I thought was cool as well. The game also has more than one ending, so if it's something that you're wanting to replay and make a different choice, that is something you can do as well. Now, I think that Observer has done a phenomenal job with its audio and visual design. The world is interesting and it's immersive, and I think the game manages to create a really creepy, claustrophobic atmosphere. And when the anomalies start crossing over from the hacked world into the real world, you really do start to question your sanity. So as an experience, I would say that Observer is excellent. But for me as a game, I felt that it could have done with more actual gameplay mechanics and things like that. The detective sections lack some depth since there was very little to actually investigate. The puzzles were relatively simple, there weren't a lot of puzzles, and the scanners didn't really serve much purpose outside of a few items that you could scan at the particular crime scenes. They didn't really seem to have any purpose to interact with the other elements in the world. The pull-taking mechanic, I think, suffered from the same issue as well. Observer is essentially a walking simulator set in a cyberpunk world that creates unease by assaulting your mind rather than scaring you with jump scares or gore. It took me around 5 to 6 hours to finish my first playthrough. Now, if you don't like walking simulators and prefer a game that's got actual more meat with regard to gameplay mechanics, this game is probably not going to change your mind. But if you are looking for something that's more of a journey and an experience, and you don't mind that the gameplay is on the sparse side, I think there's a lot to like here in Observer. It's a new approach, and I think it's actually quite refreshing. The one thing I do want to note though is that I did come across certain sections of the game that had some frame rate drops and things like that, but for the most part it was quite a stable performing title. But anyways guys, I think that's been a look at Observer. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a like and share it. If you didn't like it, there is the dislike button as well. Thanks very much for watching guys, I've been Xiaoling, until next time.